So, hi everyone, this is Ankita, and today you are tuned in to peoplemoon.com. We are having with us someone pretty special today. He's currently basking in all the glory which is coming his way from Patal Lok. But what surprises me is, you've already been in this career for 16 years, and this has not come, I would say, very early to you. Do you regret it, or are you really enjoying the phase?
No, I'm pretty much enjoying, and I don't see it as a 16 years or 14 years. I think it's like those were my growing up years, those were my learning years. You know, those were the years where I worked on something else. So I never had regrets because I was always close to things. But close to, I think, for instance, I was 22. I think so. Since then I've been, you know, either casting or doing some small parts or. So just to be on a film set, or just to be around filmmakers, or just to be around, you know, on a film set, that's the biggest high I used to get then. And now, yes, I mean, how can I not even complain that, you know, I'm getting all the acclaim for the acting part. So that only, like, you know, keeps me motivated, and I'm hopeful that, you know, in due course of time, maybe I'll be able to do some more crazy characters. So I'm really happy about it.
But if I look at your trajectory, especially in the web space per se, you are inclined towards something dark always. What's it? Like, what makes you go towards the grayer side of the spectrum? I am presuming maybe Kali 2 is dark as well, so why not?
Yeah, exactly. Kali 2, see, the thing is that I feel that when I do comedy, there's a part of me which you see there. It's, you know, not only the character, it's also Abhishek Banerjee, because I'm having fun with it, and I'm usually somebody who loves to crack jokes, or, you know, just have a great chatter session with friends and everything. So, but what happens when you're doing the negative shade, that's when you're actually, like, you know, leaving yourself, and, you know, you're trying to become somebody else. So it's very enticing, very entertaining for me, and for me especially. And that's why I think I take a lot of fun in doing those parts. Take my own time to get into them, and I really enjoy the process of those negative or, you know, whatever those dark shaped characters.
But isn't it difficult at times to do you carry your characters with you? Like, do they stay with you, or you are able to shrug them off?
So initially I had an issue. I had an issue with Ajji. Ajji is a film which is on Netflix, so I had an issue with that, where I was wondering how to, you know, get in and get out of character, because it was a very, very plain dark character. I play a child abuser there, so it was, you know, disturbing to, you know, even understand how the psyche works. So I never wanted to understand. But I think eventually after that character, I learned that, you know, I have to, like, you know, somehow try to keep the characters on set, and the minute I leave sets, you know, I become somebody else. And that's what I've been practicing. I think while doing Kali 2, I don't think I ever took Jin Liang back home. If I took Jin Liang back home, I'll be landing up in jail. So thank God I'm not doing that. Thank God I'm not that method of actor. You know, so I don't want to, like, you know, be a drug lord or, you know, kill people. That's not me. So,
and get kicked out of home as well. Your wife will also be kicking you out of home.
Obviously. She's like, she's the Jin Liang and Hathoda Jaggi of my life. So. No, I can't take
from
that, the real world.
But tell me something, Abhishek. I of course, everyone loved Patal Lok, so did I. But I have a pertinent question. When a series is success, is it easy that suddenly all the controversies come to the fore, be it any? And I'm not going to get into which exactly, be it a casting one, be it a racism allegation. Is it mostly because you are successful and it's easy to get into the limelight, or people genuinely have issues? Because if you go through a certain context of some people, it doesn't make sense.
I was speaking to a certain filmmaker about it, and I was speaking about, you know, I have always been a human being who has always questioned. I've questioned the system, or questioned, you know, whatever is around, and that questioning should be there. And that creative questions and those debates and those arguments and those conversations are a part of our industry, are a part of any creative industry. So I feel that it should be there. Whether a problem here, I think rather than bringing it up while something is successful, like as you said, racism or any of those allegations which I think filmmakers constantly fall into, you know, and I feel that it should happen when nobody's talking about it. That is
exactly.
When dialogue. You know, that is when it is a dialogue. Why do people always question things after they're successful? So they're trying to, you know, compare the success and bring it down. The whole point is when you're trying to bring something down. Rather, we should celebrate a, you know, good project, and whatever issues you have, bring them. You know, bring them from time to time so that there can be a dialogue, so that there can be a conversation. And maybe we work towards a better system where people don't feel the way they feel. You know, and we have to also be responsible towards people, because they are the ones who are actually watching our show. So we have to be responsible, but not at a time when everybody is talking about it. You know, we should talk about it when maybe nobody is talking about it.
Why this question also makes sense, Abhishek. I was reading a interview of yours which made a lot of sense, like particularly this Nepali character which has suddenly come to the fore under the racism allegations. There was a beautiful process while you selected her, like the actor, I would say, precisely there. Then, and till now, very strangely, the actor hasn't come up and spoken up a single thing. I don't understand exactly who is having the issue and where is the issue. That is my entire debate. How do we underline that? It boggles my mind.
You know, I feel what's happened is that spoon feeding has become a process. So everybody is taking the lines or whatever the character is saying on the surface level. They're not understanding where it's coming from. I think the minute they understand the sarcasm, the satire to the society, maybe they will understand that it is not, you know, against, but it is actually for the cause. So yeah, that's what it is. You know, the interpretations can be different and varied, but one needs to understand why the writer has written that, why it is coming out like that, and question it, analyze it, and maybe then raise questions. That's what I'm saying. Raising questions should never stop, but you need to raise the right question. That's all.
Exactly, because then suddenly people are also having issues that why you name a dog called Shavitri, that in Bengali it's the most normal thing to pet your way that way. I was like, everything can't be under the scanner. Like, you can't have everything under the scanner.
There will be a time when they will question the mustache, where it's like, ye grey kyun hai? Kyun hai grey? Why is the mustache grey?
Yeah, I think suddenly people who are advocating for censorship on a web and people who were not wanting censorship, suddenly we as audience have turned censor. We just want everything according to our own will, and the creative freedom is somewhere getting... do you think we are unable to express now? This way will hamper expressing our stories, because web takes that privilege of expressing stories in a longer format.
Yeah, and I think... I feel that every vision should be out there, yeah. Every filmmaker, every writer, whatever they want to make, it should be out there. Without hurting any sentiments, of course. Like, you know, nobody wants to hurt sentiments, yeah. Nobody is intending to do that. But if some sentiments are hurt, they need to, you know, question, and maybe some answers need to be given to them, to maybe explain to them that, you know, it's not it's not against the society, it's for the society. Whatever they're trying to show, or whatever any filmmaker is trying to show. But it will happen. I think we are in a free country. People have freedom of speech. They will say whatever they want to. And we will keep evolving and trying to, you know, bring up the same things in different means and different ways. It will never stop.
I also noticed something which actually I failed to notice in the first time, was your association with Anushka. It's not just this. You people go back from Filori days to write screenwriter on Pari, if I am not wrong here.
So screenwriter of Pari is another Abhishek Banerjee. He's my namesake.
Okay, and I am like, this was new. I need to check with Abhishek. He's writing scripts as well.
No. It's a huge miscommunication which has happened through Google and IMDb links. And there's another Abhishek Banerjee who's my namesake who has written it. Poor guy, he's not got a credit on Google. I'm telling you, producers have called me and they've told me that I didn't write. I'm like, sir, I didn't write. And they got pissed off with me. So they're like, maybe I'm lying to them or something like that. But no, I'm a writer. I'm not a writer. Yes, but yes, Pillori is the one where I acted with her first, and it was amazing. I still remember those days and the shooting process and everything. It was a lot of fun. Always loved her, always loved the company, Karne Sharma, everybody, because I think that it's one of the sweetest pieces I've met. And also the back, the kind of content which maybe a producer should try and back.
Exactly.
Something different, something which is relevant, something which is breaking the cliche, breaking the
bad. Why I ask the question is, Anushka finally came out and started talking about Patalok. She kept mum for quite a long time. And we're also getting the hints of maybe a part two. Now they killed your character. I'm giving away the spoiler. I think everyone has seen it. Will there be a regret? Will I have a regret? I won't be there to see you. But just in case, like, because it's been such a huge hit.
See, the thing is that that's what we need to move on from the time and era where Jon Snow comes back. I think that was the biggest mistake I think Game of Thrones those guys did. I think you know he should have never come back. And that's what if you remember, like you know, till that point we always remembered the show. We were always attracted, but the minute it is becoming easy, the audience will lose the connection. So nothing should be easy, it should be earned. I don't know, I don't think a character has just one life, he has many lives because he lived on. For me, the Bounder lived on, and I totally feel that Adora Tyagi will live on too. But yeah, I'm happy that I've moved on to some other character. I don't have the pressure of pulling off the same character in the same, you know, with as much whatever, you know, competence and everything. So I'm actually happy and relaxed that it's done in one time.
I remember the best comments which I have read coming for you were he loved dogs and that's it, everything stopped here. He loved dogs. I'm like, okay, now this is a strong case. This is the first time ever a series delivering a socio-political commentary has put a very strong light on, very slyly, on the welfare of animal being, which I think I haven't also even noticed before. You pick up something so beautifully and very slightly and let it do the talking. Like your Jane scene is something which is my favorite personally. Like,
I love that scene.
Smile on your face, now then the dog escapes. It's like, good, huh? That was lovely. I have to give it to you. But Abhishek, also one more thing I just wanted to check with you. Now when you are venturing as an actor also in a Bengali space with Kali, does language serves as a barrier or is it easy to adapt to even the new?
It's very difficult, in fact. It's very difficult because I'm a Hindi speaker. My first language is Hindi. So Bengali is my third language. First language is Hindi, then English, then I speak Bengali. Because Bengali is something which I speak only with my Bengali friends or my mom and dad. But Zindagi mein Hindi bolta hu, kaam karte hue jab Bengali se Hindi, whatever. So for me, the most tricky part was to maintain both the characters alike. So when you're saying a line, it sounds in a way you have a different rhythm. When you say it in Bengali, it sounds different. So you know, but both those characters need to be same. You know, like Hindi bol rahe, Bengali bol rahe, wo to hai ki. So that was a very difficult part. But I hope I managed it. I hope I don't get any slack from my Bengali. There's no controversy ki isko Bengali bolni nahi aati, Bengali kaise.
And you have a certain knack after comedy. I think people who all were alleging that Abhishek and comedy are becoming synonymous, suddenly Abhishek and thrillers and mysteries are becoming synonymous. Everything thrilling on Abhishek.
I just want Abhishek and acting to be synonymous. You know, that's what I want. And I want people to always get surprised and shocked I think jahan bhi wo log sochna shuru karenge ki this is where he's going, I'm going to change it. That's what I'm going to do. So it's going to be a game between me and the audience.
But Abhishek, you had it the hard way. I would say, of course, everyone has a fair share of struggles. What I'm asking is, can we take the actor out of Abhishek and keep the casting director, or can we take the casting director out of Abhishek and just keep the actor? Give me a choice.
I do that all the time. I think if you speak to Amar Kaushik, he one day came up to me on set, and I have a habit of, you know, always being on the phone. Everybody's irritated about it. My entire personal life is, you know, everybody just hates it that I'm always on the phone. So what happens is, if I'm just, I just acted, cut, you know, cut, okay, but I'm
strikes you that, oh, some other actor could have been a better suited for this particular part I am going to play. Has it ever happened? Have you ever been in a fix like that?
Initially, earlier I used to do very tiny roles, minuscule roles. Those were not, obviously I never thought that I was not even casting for. But I don't think that happens, because somewhere I believe in myself also as an actor. And when somebody, thinks of me and he feels that I can pull it off or something, I take it as a challenge. I take it as, a learning experience for me. And I don't think in that direction. I think I can switch off and switch on like that. There are times when I'm thinking whether I will be able to do it or not. There is always this doubt in me. But eventually, I think I work hard towards it and pull it off. I don't think I have ever thought like that.
Okay, I'll try that. I'm saying the success is beautiful right now. But are you scared? Lastly, that's all I want to ask. Are you scared? Because success comes huge responsibility.
No, I'm not scared at all. And in fact, this is the first time I'm not scared in life. There was a lot of fear where I was wondering whether I will be able to actually pull off characters, or whether I'll be able to pull off something like Hathoda or something like Dilli and Link Kali too. These are characters which are very far away from me. So the fear was that whether I'm actually good enough to pull off these characters. I don't know about how the audience is going to react to Dilli, but for me the achievement is that I have done it. Shooting complete, kar li, mujhe sab paise bhi de diye, tareef bhi kar rahe hain. So my fears chali gayi hai. Haan, telling you, I'm very happy. I'm an individual who's happy with smallest of. मुझे छोटी छोटी चीजों में खुशी मिल जाती है. इफ आई एम ऑन सेट विद परेश रावल, आई मीट हिम एंड आई फील वेरी हैप्पी एंड पॉसिबल सम लाइक कि ओ यार आई एम वर्किंग विद परेश रावल, वन ऑफ द ग्रेटेस्ट एक्टर्स ऑफ इंडिया. एंड दैट्स द काइंड ऑफ हैप्पीनेस आई वांट. आई हैव सीन दिस इंडस्ट्री सिंस अ चाइल्ड, आई हैव बीन पैशनेट अबाउट इट सिंस आई वाज 4 और 5 एंड आई एम अमंगस्ट देम. और मुझे काम मिल रहा है, मुझे लोग पैसे भी दे रहे हैं, तारीफ भी कर रहे हैं. इससे डरने वाली क्या बात है? मतलब बहुत अच्छी बात हो गई.
You are active on both mediums, on films and on web as well. We are currently in a difficult situation when the industry comes. We are at crossroads. Is theatre going experience going to fall behind OTT, or is it going to be a coexisting platform for both the domains?
I think both need to survive. Both need to coexist. That's what we need. Mediums kuch bhi ho, content ban raha hai. And now when you see the kind of content which is coming up on OTT, they're also shot very well and they're almost like feature films.
The production value is grand. You can't fault it.
Exactly. So I think it's going to coexist. There is a different experience. I always say that watching something on theater, when you're going on it's like a community thing. This is all solo view. आप अकेले अकेले देख रहे हो, कनेक्ट कर रहे हो. लेकिन कुछ फिल्में होती है जो हॉल में जाके देखने में मजा आता है, उनको क्या बोलते हैं, वहाँ एंजॉय करने में मजा आता है. सो आई ऑलवेज फील दैट बोथ द एक्सपीरियंस शुड बी देयर. एंड एज एक्टर आई थिंक आई विल नेवर थिंक अबाउट द मीडियम, आई विल ऑलवेज थिंक अबाउट द स्टोरी, आई विल ऑलवेज थिंक अबाउट द कैरेक्टर, आई विल ऑलवेज थिंक अबाउट हु इज मेकिंग इट, हाउ दे आर मेकिंग इट एंड दैट. वो अच्छे से काम बनाएंगे ना तो यहाँ पे हो या वहाँ पे हो, दोनों जगह पे इट विल बी धरती लोग या स्वर्ग लोग दोनों में चलेगा.
कॉम्प्लीमेंट किसने दिया जाते जाते आपको अभी तक?
सबसे अच्छा कॉम्प्लीमेंट तो मुझे आई थिंक ये द I don't think it's not a compliment, but I'm liking the Indian Thor, the Thor memes and everything. I'm enjoying that. You know, that's something I never expected in my life, that I will be in a meme with Chris Hemsworth, who is like, you know, the Thor. And I never expected he is pretty hatty to hai wo uske saath out aayega. So I'm very, very happy and, you know, very proud of myself that I've made myself to be in the same meme where Thor is. Because Thor is also, he happens to be my favorite superhero. So, yeah. He happens to be my favorite superhero.
We should be giving you a pat on back. Thank you so much for the lovely work. And I'm not going to ask you to spill the beans about what's next. We will be staying tuned and we'll be keeping a close watch what you're going to offer us next.
Yes. And I hope you guys like Kali too. Yeah, like watch and let me know. And
you are in demand.
Demand ka pata nahi. Hum to bas mazdoor hain. Jitni bhi matlab kaam karayenge, we'll do it.
And thank you so much for giving us the time. Thank you
so much. Lovely talking to you. Bye.